When it was time to get it lit, we got it hot like fever.
Sick with the talk, pass to your receiver.
All about running the spot.
And you know we got breath control, so no need to take a breather.
Cardio kingpin.
Subjugate the dub play.
And you know we can't wait to bring spins.
A-star quizzes, A-plus the final.
Vocals we align, we'll move it all simultaneous.
Leo and Joyce, you rock.
We earn
30 years, so you can say we got.
Three turns.
Live off the board, unlike you and your chessmen.
We install doubt in you and your yes men.
And if the game had veins, we'll insert
upheaval the crown.
Cause the adrenaline we blend with the sound is our thing.
We're leaving the kings of all crown.
So, are you ready?
Ready?
Are you set?
Set?
Then jump to the rhythm as hard as you can go.
Keep it steady.
Steady.
To the letter, right?
Bang.
Turn it up, y'all peak the flow.
But can you rock it like rocket fuel?
What you talking about? Space out your mind.
But can you rock it like rocket fuel?
That's a close encounter of what kind?
Ready, set, steady.
Coach, it is a sound like no other when they raise that 12th man flag here in Seattle. We just heard it, and that means it's time for football at CenturyLink Field. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Los Angeles Rams and the Seattle Seahawks. The NFL season has hit high gear, and off we go in Week 11 on EA Sports. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told as he's taken down back shy of the 20.
Got my 20!
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. It's a Rams first down on a pickup of 10. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A huge play that time for the Rams. 64 yards.
Here we go. By 20. 54. Where was that?
And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down. So they get pushed back to the 11, and here's second and goal.
Hey, Irvin.
Now gone. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal. This stadium once registered as the loudest roar ever recorded, and you can hear him now, third and goal.
X3, 218, jump.
Now a handoff looking right, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1. Interesting decision. I could see if you're on the 1-yard line, push it in, you're at home, but from this distance.
How far would you push it? 2-yard line, 3-yard line? Because we're beyond the 4. So this is what we're talking about now. This is a long way. And I know it's a disappointment to come away without getting a touchdown after that drive. But how about coming away with no points by going for it, not getting it? Bring out the field goal kicker. Get 3 and move on.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. On the ground, this is Rashad Penny. And a nice move will yield nothing as he stopped behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
It's third.
Mike is 59.
On third down, Wilson. He'll have a first down past the 40. He's got Lockett as he'll get this one up to the 44-yard line. First down, Seattle, 16 yards the gain there. A first down carry, and he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense, because you're excited about hitting him in the first half, maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. Coverage there by Brian Body Calhoun.
And 8 yards to go.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Here's Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The start of this game shaping up nicely on that visiting sideline.
Yeah, how about that? You get your points on the opening drive, then you get a big sack there on third down, and you make the home crowd go.
There is a hush indeed. Oh, he's going to go ahead and field it from the 3-yard line. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Rams will go on offense here with a 1st and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And still a lot of football to be played in this season. We're only in November. A lot can happen between now and January. But if it ended today, they would just be on the... He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Wilson now off the bootleg. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. And at the 37-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
After the interception, here's Goff. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
So now 20 yards to go on 2nd down after the sack. Work to be done. Here's Goff. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. 3-0 after 1 on EA Sports. So Goff, he'll try to refocus after the sack. The Rams now set up with a tough one, a 3rd and long. From the gun, here's Goff. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's 4th down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. And this works out well as it'll kick out of bounds at the 11-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football. They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Let's not quibble about the game there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
They'll try to run for it with Penny. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26. They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue.
First down. First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
Let's
Here we go. Watch tight. Tight end right. Watch tight. Tight end right.
And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there. But it'll be second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
To throw again on second down. Wilson. And that going to be incomplete. A lot of contact, no call, and it's third down.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, as it turned out. Couldn't even find his outlet, man, because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
The Seahawks on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. Now it's Wilson. They set up the screen to Penny. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. Now the screen only good for 3 that time, and it'll bring up a fourth down. Now here's Michael Dixon as he'll punt it away for the second time. Yards on the return that time, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1, and that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And it appears we've got a member of the Rams shaken up on that last play. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. And some space here. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. It's a gain of 15, and the Rams have a first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Rams tack on to their advantage.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Point after, right down the middle. And the lead grows to 10-0.
Rams 10, Seahawks 9.
out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. A running play there, going to get 10 and a quick first down. 10 yards and a Seattle first down.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. I think if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
They'll go jet sweep here with Dorsett. And that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. On second and 11 now. Wilson, it's caught. Lockett. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
It's a game of four. Makes it third.
The Seahawks on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the first half. 10-0, our score. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. And able to find Dorsett. First down Seattle on a pickup of 13. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. This is Freeman on 1st and 10. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
The 1st down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. There's Wilson to throw. He's got the 1st down here inside the 30. And this is going to be another 1st down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 25-yard line. He's been the forgotten man in this first half. Not a guy you want to forget. Not only his first catch, first time they've targeted him.
That doesn't make any sense, does it? Because those are the types of plays that he prefers.
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on 2nd down. Now it's Wilson. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to 3rd down. Now the Seahawks call the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the 2nd quarter. This will be the 8th play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. From the gun, it's Wilson. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. An inaugural trip to the red zone here for the Seahawks. They've got a 1st and goal to go at the 7. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, a chip shot here. Zerline's kick is up and through. And that will do it for this first half. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll send you eastward to Orlando, standing by with that EA Sports Halftime Report now is Jonathan Coachman. Take it away, Coach. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3.
Let's go, boys! Let's go! Check!
Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing.
And now off to the races, down the right side, and all the way in, touchdown Seattle. Rashad Penny. His 14th touchdown now on the year, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. They've done a good job of holding him down in the first half, but he explodes for a big one right there.
Yeah, I've got an image in my head of him being surrounded by a bunch of people, really, with ropes and other things trying to keep him locked in. But eventually they got tired too, and just as you noted, he broke out.
And it's a guy that usually you can only keep down for so long. Zerline good with a PAT, and we are even at 10 apiece. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. This fielded at the two.
Good work, boys. Let's go.
At their own 18-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Pretty solid run here on first down. Almost picked up another first, but he appears to be a few inches short. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. Call. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Now gone. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams. A big play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Rams have taken the lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes it a 17-10 score. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
That's a jet sweep into the hands of Metcalf, and that one covered beautifully. Their defenders stayed home, and they'll stop him behind the line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Makes it third and 15.
So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long. Out of the gun. Here's Wilson. He's got Freeman here. It's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning,
and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Averaging 50 yards of boot so far as this one's away. This is taken at the 18. 51 yards on the punt there. And out will come the offense as they take over. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
First down, Los Angeles, there with a pickup of 14 yards. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now a handoff here to his running back. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be second and 11. Goff now looking to throw. Into double coverage and it's intercepted. Trey Flowers picks it. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
Wilson leaves this one with Penny. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down. Continues to be a struggle for this offense, and this home crowd, they're growing a little restless here in the second half.
And I think they've just got to look at how they're trying to move the football. Yeah, you want to run it, but maybe you spread it out, maybe some swing passes that can take the place of runs and give you a little more space.
4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible. Hope he's got man-to-man coverage and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
On third down, Wilson. And that is incomplete.
Well, this at least is the right idea. I think they've got to get the tight end more involved.
He had just one target in the first half, incomplete. Now incomplete here with the first target of the second half.
Yeah, should not stop them at all from going back to him. Find it.
And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. Down here in the third quarter, obviously that's one they could have used.
Yeah, and one of my favorite special teams coaches in the NFL told me what separates the kickers in the NFL versus the ones who are not is not the misses, it's the second miss in a row. Best kickers in the league, they don't miss two in a row. He's got to get his head back together in case he gets another shot. One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Throwing again on second down. Goff. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Quandre Diggs. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Wilson. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. Call it a loss of 8 yards on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. From the shotgun, Wilson. Dorsett's got it. And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25. They get 12 yards back, but it still leads to a fourth and long. Now here's Michael Dixon. He's been terrific so far. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. Fielded at the 20. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 15, and the Rams have a first down.
And while we're seeing more and more of these plays come from the college game into the NFL, and that one, it was run with great success, how about the evolution of the offensive linemen? We're seeing less and less big guys who can't move and more guys who are a lot more mobile and can get out in front of that type of a play.
Defensively, a solid response after giving up back-to-back first downs. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. A shotgun snap for Goff. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. That's good for 28 yards. Well, probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this fourth quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
They'll try and run for him, first and goal. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard that time, second and goal. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal. Mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It'll be a gain of 5, but they do keep him out of the end zone, and now it's fourth down. And his kick here is good. And they double him up here. That makes our score 20-10. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Throwing on second and long. Wilson. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Now, he's been a busy man out of the backfield. They've looked his way quite a bit so far in this game.
Nice job there defensively, though, adjusting, because a couple of his earlier catches, he was wide open. Not that time.
You mentioned the key word, adjustment. A better
in trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now, boy, the ball is going to go over on downs here inside the 10-yard line. So this one fairly well in the bag as they take over with a first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown Rams. A great play there. His second touchdown of the night. And the Rams tack on to their advantage.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. You can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Let's just feel it at the goal line. And he'll get it up just past the 20, and his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. Here's the Seattle offense ready to get this drive underway. They're down big here late. I don't know. Just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll toss it to Penny. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
Green 80! Alert.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Wilson and the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. One last shot for Wilson. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
Foot on the gas, I will not crash, they will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone, watch me. Celebrate, I'm cocky. I do my dance, jump in the stands, no man the man, Odell with the hands, thought he could guard me, I ruin they plans, I do what I want, they do what they can, got it on smash, foot on the gas, I will not crash, honey y'all dash, honey y'all dash, honey y'all dash, honey y'all dash, honey, I dash, yeah. They can't catch up cause they lacking the stamina. Way too advanced to be playing with amateurs. They on attack when they tackle like damager. They react and play it back on the camera. Hot boy, just consider me flammable. Sure shot, I got all the intangibles. Need a leash, I'm a beast, I'm an animal. Eat the competition up like a Hannibal. Know the game like I wrote up the manual. I do weekly what you do on the annual. MVP, that decision unanimous. Big dogs, I don't think they can handle it. Battlefield, it's just me and my warriors. Guaranteed we emerging victorious. Years blessed, sweat, tears, it's glorious. I remember when they all was ignoring us. Dash, got it on, smash, foot on the gas, I will not crash, they will not stop me. Tenfold, copy, end zone, watch me. Celebrate, I'm cocky. I do my dance, jump in the stands, no man the man, Odell with the hands, thought he could guard me, I ruin they plans, I do what I want, they do what they riding on smash. Put on the gas. I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash.
They slept on the team that they owe me. I need a ring and a trophy. I say I'm the best because I am. It's no need in keeping it low-key. I can carve up the D like a turkey. I run straight through the D like a train. This year we ain't taking no losses. It's all about making the game. I hear a lot of trash talk. He call himself making a name. I put on the jets. The coach will regret even letting him stay in the game. Team morale took a tumble. Next time be humble. I'm the lion in the jungle. You just trying not to fumble. Rumble, young man, rumble. Never slip nor stumble. I take off, poof, magic. Now watch me juke through the traffic. Footwork fantastic. Dominating every facet. Treat the pocket like plastic. Here come the blitz, pass it.
Got it on smash. Put on the gas. I will not crash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash. Honey, y'all dash.
My name, huh?
You ready?
S-T-R-O. I ain't come to play with you.
Yeah.
Life challenging, but I wouldn't trade with you.
Trade.
It's early, I'm up.
Yeah.
I can't spend the day with you. I'm minding my business. I ain't getting paid with you.
Nope.
My color bright.
Yeah.
I ain't finna fade with you. Man, I gotta come clean like I'm made with you. I've been on my everybody drop when I drop.
Yeah.
Looking shorty, she support, bruh. Lifting up never not on my grind. New York City time. Another brother better, you will never find. I've been in my bag like groceries. Competition shouldn't take shots, take notes, please. Reporting live from the winner's side. Ready to try, keep a different vibe. Is you down the ride, never tired. You will never know, you ain't never tried. Work it out, hit the gym, hit the field. Hey, yo, I need that. Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard, on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase the rings. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase the rings. Now what I do? Lace up the shoes, chase the rings. Yeah. Beats, leave it in the street, chase on the news.
What I do? Lace up my shoes, chase W's. Great colored coupes, uno, no, I can't be number two. MVP the league, most valuable, they sweet as apple juice. Talking trophies, I didn't grab the few, can't match this attitude. I wear my heart on my sleeve, please. I move like the wind, can't catch this breeze, freeze. Stop you in your tracks, there's not no preseason. We seeking W's like Tupac used to throw up. Forget it, might as well forfeit your team, shouldn't even show up. What you wanna be when you grow up? They used to ask me. Naturally, I chose an athlete. Competition never matched me. We ain't go together like camouflage and polka dots. Focus on your position, just know your spot. Sure, don't stop. It's a long season. They planning on winning for the wrong reasons. Trying to get my number retired. Can't let these frauds beat us. I figured out the recipe. Never let opponents get the best of me. I'm focused on my legacy.
Big chips, man, I need that. Hustle hard on the job, you can see that. On my head is real good, we don't need your feedback. They clear the way with my crew coming through. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's. What I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's. Now what I do? Lace up the shoes, chase W's. Yeah. Play the beats, leave it in the street, case on the news.
The throne. I ain't a king, not a pawn. Hop on a jet, cross the gold. I guess the world is my homie. There's so many milkers burning my dome and like turbulent air. I'm switching these flows. If you look at my neck, boy, I'm letting it snow. I'm sturdy as hell, it's a vessel alone. They showing me love in my city. Gangs ain't hippies. Women like Nicki know what I'm about. I'm not the stereotypes. They do not fit me. I'm bigger than life. Gave everyone jobs. I'm not a guard. Go hop with a squad. I'm playing my part. But them LeBron. Rings of the team.